okay, I want to talk about substantiality and sensitivity and how they correspond to yin and yang. Now in Tai Chi, a leg that is actively engaged in holding your body up, the muscles actively engaged, is called your yang leg. It's not readily available to do other actions with because it's holding your body up. Your other leg, your yin leg, this is more receptive, more adaptable. It's free because it's not actively engaged to either step or kick. Now the same thing can be found in the arms. There's a saying in Tai Chi that when one part moves, the whole body moves. And there's also references to the six harmonies, one of the external harmonies being that the hand and the foot harmonise. And quite often this means that they literally move together with a kind of omnidirectional muscle state called Pung or Hun Yuan Li. It's a small amount of sort of switched onness, structural integrity, so that the body isn't flaccid. But it's not the same as being really switched on, and it's not in any way isolated to any specific part of the body. It's an intelligent, adaptable, receptive form of strength. That's Pung. So this whole side of the body is yin or receptive when there's no weight on the leg, the leg's free to step and the arm is free to come out and operate as a feeler or a sensor or an antenna. Okay, so say my attacker is to bring in any kind of attack. Okay, I'm just going to deal with upper body here. Okay, initially I might execute a sort of pun kind of technique, a warding off technique. But this arm is coming out as a feeler, basically. The foot and the arm are moving together. And I'm going to feel the force. I'm going to measure the oncoming force here. Okay, there's references in the classics to being like a weighing scales and measuring the oncoming force. So I might decide, if the force is very great, so she's really lunging in, that I need to yield to that incoming force and then just help her on her way. Alternatively, I might feel a little bit less force. I might decide that I can divert that off course without having to yield quite so much. And then maybe striking in here or potentially even driving on through here and here. Okay. I might decide that I want to come completely around it and come right into my opponent here. This is if I'm feeling like the force is, you know, not so great that I need to really yield very much to it. I might be able to divert it with a very small amount. My 4 ounces being used to divert 1,000 pounds before I go on in. I may decide to do something even more aggressive if the force feels very light, or if I've actually chosen, if they were in the guard stance, to initiate combat. And upon meeting quite a weak amount of structure, quite a weak amount of strength, I might decide to seize the initiative and deliberately, purposely uproot the opponent, pull them off guard. I could also do that to the inside. Yeah. So to summarise my three main options, this is something that's part of my universal martial training system. I refer to it as the three spheres. Basically, I can draw an opponent into my sphere, I can crash into their sphere, or else we can treat the combat as a sphere, and the midway point, the point of contact between us, is the centre of that kind of third sphere. My three main options are: as force comes in, I can yield to a great force and just pull my opponent into my sphere. alternatively, against a moderate force, I can move them a little bit and move me a little bit, divert them off course a little and move around it. Or tactically, I might want to move around in a more active way here, or a Bagua kind of approach. Or against a very weak force, I might purposely decide to dominate, just crash in. Those are my main options.